Have you ever noticed the door of the refrigerator gets closed quickly when moved towards it? In the same way, the door of the cupboard also closes as soon as it reaches close to the cupboard. The button-like lock sticks to the back surface quickly. How do all these processes happen? The answer is the application of magnets. All these items have a magnet which attracts the magnetic material or magnet attached to the door or the bag. We have been seeing magnets since childhood. But what is a magnet? Why do they attract some particular metals? Why does this happen? In today's video, we'll answer some of the similar questions related to magnets. Magnets are usually iron metal oxides that attract certain metals such as iron, cobalt, and nickel. Magnet has two poles, the north and the south. There are three types of magnets we see: bar magnet, horseshoe magnet, and ring magnet. Bar magnet is in the form of a bar having north and south poles at the extreme corners. Horseshoe magnet looks like a horseshoe only. Similarly, the shape of a ring magnet is like the shape of a ring. Magnetic field and field lines. If two bar magnets are taken, it is seen that the north pole of one attracts the south pole of the other, and the like poles of both the magnets repel each other. We know that the magnets attract iron but not wood. After seeing these attractions and repulsion, it would be fair to say that something is happening around the magnet that our eyes cannot see. To understand this, let's perform an activity. To perform this activity, we need a bar magnet, iron fillings, and a white sheet. Place the bar magnet at the center of the sheet and slowly pour iron fillings over it. Tap the sheet like this 2-3 times. If you look at the fillings closely, a formed pattern can be seen. This pattern shows the force exerted by the magnet on the iron fillings. The field in which the force is exerted is called the magnetic field. The lines on which the fillings can be seen are known as magnetic field lines. If we carefully observe the iron fillings, then we'll find that at one place they are collected very closely and at other places very less. The collection of iron fillings represents the strength or weakness of magnetic field lines. According to the convention, the direction of field lines is taken from the north to south. Inside the magnet, it is taken from south to north. So today we got to know about magnetic field, which we can't see with our naked eyes. Besides that, we learnt about the field lines too. I hope whenever you see any magnet attracting any magnetic material, then you will keep the magnetic field in your mind and will definitely spread the word with those who don't know about it. Hello friends, today's video will not start with an example or an activity, but rather with a story that changed the definition of science. What happened is, when electric current was flowing through a metal wire, the compass kept nearby showed a kind of reflection. Then Oersted realized that electricity also produces magnetic effect. But what is this magnetic effect? Does it increase and decrease with electric current, or is it always constant? Would this magnetic effect be like a magnet or different from it? Similar questions will be emphasized in today's video. So first of all, we need to know what this small round looking device is. This device is called magnetic compass, which is used to find the direction of Earth's magnetic field. Our Earth also acts like a big magnet, which you will study in the higher classes. Also, this compass is used to show direction. The needle of this magnet is just like an ordinary magnet, which has north and south poles. The north pole is marked with red color and the needle on this point towards the geographical north pole. As we said that this needle is a magnet, what would happen if a magnet was brought near this compass? They can either attract each other or get repelled. If the north pole of the bar magnet is brought near the compass, it will attract the south pole of the compass towards it. Similarly, the south pole of the bar magnet will attract the north pole of the compass. Let's perform this experiment to understand ostrich work. To perform this experiment, we need a battery, a piece of thick copper wire, a compass and connecting wires. The battery must be connected to the two ends of the copper wire via switch. Place the compass over the copper wire in such a way that the needle of the compass and the copper wire are parallel to each other. As soon as we put on the switch, we see a deflection in the compass needle. Exactly the same deflection as it was in the case of a bar magnet. We can consider the bar magnet and the current carrying wire to be the same, and it would be fair to say that electricity also has some magnetic effects on the surroundings. If electricity has magnetic effects, then like the magnet, it must have magnetic field and field lines. Let's understand this closely. What will happen if the direction of electric current is changed in the circuit? The deflection of the needle will be in the opposite direction, which means that changing the direction of electric current also changes the direction of magnetic field lines. In order to know the direction of the lines, a little change will have to be made in this experiment. We will keep the parameters in a vertical direction. Then an emitter must be connected in series along with a piece of cardboard placed around the copper wire with the help of a stand. Pour iron filings on the cardboard. After putting on the switch and tapping the cardboard twice or thrice, a circular pattern formed by the filings can be seen. This pattern is nothing else but the magnetic field lines. To find the direction of these lines, a compass can be put on the cardboard. The deflected needle will show the direction of field lines. Hence, it is proved that electric current possesses magnetic fields around the conductor. But if we increase the electric current, then what will happen? The deflection also increases and the strength of magnetic field lines also increases. Also, if we reverse the direction of the current, then the direction of field lines also gets reversed. We have experimented with the increasing and decreasing and reversing the direction of the current. What effect does this change in the size of the wire have on the magnetic field? Let's find out the answer. Take a piece of thick copper wire. See, the deflection has increased with the thickness of the wire. That means the strength of magnetic field lines has also increased. We have learnt a lot of things in today's video. You might find it difficult to remember all the facts. Let's make it easier for you with the help of a right-hand thumb rule. If we need to find the direction of magnetic field lines around a current carrying conductor, then the right-hand thumb rule will help you. This rule states that, imagine you are holding a current carrying straight conductor in your right hand, such that the thumb points towards your direction of current. Then your fingers will wrap around the conductor in the direction of the field lines of the magnetic field. Let's summarize what we have learned today. A current carrying conductor acts like a magnet. If the electric current is increased, then the strength of magnetic field lines also increases. The strength of magnetic field lines is directly proportional to the thickness of the current carrying conductor. We will learn about the appliances working on electricity and magnetism in our upcoming videos. We have learned magnetic field lines due to current carrying straight conductor so far. We also know that due to science, there is no limit to think. If a magnetic field can be possessed in a current carrying straight conductor, then what will happen if we put a circular loop in place of a straight conductor? When the electric current is passed through the loop, the pattern starts to form here too. The pattern is similar to the former one in some ways and different in others. Yes, filings are forming the circular patterns, but because of the loop, two circular patterns are being formed. If we apply the right hand thumb rule here, then we can get the direction of magnetic field lines easily. At the surface, current is flowing in the upward direction, then the fingers wrapping the conductor will tell the direction of the field lines. At the surface, current is flowing in the downward direction, then field lines will be in this direction. As we move away from the conductor, the size of the pattern increases. It will be a straight line as we move at the center. This is the case with the power magnets too. What will happen if you look at the apparatus from behind? The direction of the current will be reversed. And the field lines too will be in the opposite direction than the former. The side of the loop will work as the south pole where the field lines are seen going inwards. And the side where the field lines are seen coming outwards will work as the north pole. The direction can be remembered easily using this method. If the current is flowing in the clockwise direction, then that side will be the south pole. It can be remembered by the arrows formed on the S. If the current is flowing in anti-clockwise direction, then this side will act as the north pole. It is denoted by N. I hope you will never forget the concept of these north and south poles. You must be thinking what was the reason behind understanding the circular loop. You will get to know the reason by the end of this video. What will happen if you take a number of loops and make a coil out of it in place of a single loop? This coil in terms of science is known as solenoid. If we apply electricity through the solenoid, then iron filings will make the pattern here too. That means there are magnetic fields too. To find the direction of the field lines, we will look at the direction of current at both the sides. On this side, the current is flowing in clockwise direction. That means this will be the south pole of the solenoid based on the rule we learned before. On this side, the current is flowing in an anti-clockwise direction. That means this will be the north pole of the solenoid. In this way, we can see the field lines easily. If you look closely at the image, it will make us remember the power magnet. So can we make a magnet with the help of a solenoid? Yes, this is possible. If we put a soft iron core in the solenoid and put on the electricity, then this iron core will work as the magnet only. The magnets formed with the help of electricity are known as electromagnets. These electromagnets are used in various appliances like fans, electric motors, washing machines, and generators. By this video, we have learnt about the current carrying circular loop and solenoid, how to make an electromagnet with the help of the solenoid. But how to use electromagnets in appliances like motors, we'll learn about this in upcoming videos after understanding Fleming's left hand rule. As we saw in our last video, that a current carrying conductor produces a magnetic field around it. It also affects the magnetic field of the compass kept nearby. But we also know by Newton's third law of motion that to every action there is an equal and opposite reaction. Here too the law is followed. If the current carrying conductor exerts a force on the magnet and the compass, then the same force is exerted on the conductor as well. But does it really make any sense? Yes, it is true. Let's perform an activity to understand this. To perform this activity, we need a horseshoe magnet, a piece of copper wire, a stand, a battery, a switch, and connecting wires. First of all, put the horseshoe magnet on the stand such that the north pole should be vertically above the south pole. Hang the copper wire between the poles of the magnet with the help of the stand and connect its ends with the positive and negative terminal of the battery. Put on the switch after completing the circuit. We can see the deflection in wire in one direction. The deflection can be seen till the switch is on. How is this even possible? What will happen if the direction of the current is changed? Let's do this too. It can be seen that the deflection changes its direction as we change the direction of the current. But the question is, why does this happen? Let's get into the explanation one by one. The reason behind a deflection is that magnetic field produced by current carrying wire gets in contact with the magnetic field of the magnet. Both of them exerted a force on each other, and due to this deflection, we could be able to see the reflection. We got to know the reason behind a deflection in the wire, but we didn't know the answer of why the direction of deflection changes as current changed its direction. Let's find out this answer in this section of the video. Looking into it closely, we can find a pattern here as well. We know that the direction of the magnetic field lines is from north to south. When the current was flowing in this direction, then the deflection was in this direction. If we rotate the picture, we'll get to know that all the three components are perpendicular to each other. The relation among force, electric current, and the magnetic field is known as Fleming's left-hand rule. This rule states that if we stretch the index finger, middle finger, and the thumb of the left hand such that all the three are mutually perpendicular to each other, then the index finger will point out towards the direction of the magnetic field, the middle finger will point out towards the direction of the current, and the thumb will show the direction of the force. If we put this in our activity, we'll understand it better. If electric current was in this direction and magnetic field was in this, then the force would be exerted in this direction. In the same way, if the direction of the current was changed, then the force did change its direction too. We should have to learn this rule because this rule will help us in finding the direction of the force in the equipment which works on the application of electromagnets. In our next video, we will discuss the principle and working of the electric motor. You must have seen many equipments like fans, air coolers, or water pumps in your homes. Did you ever wonder how these equipments work? We understood the principle behind the glowing of the electric bulb and the role of electricity in it. But what happens when this electricity flows into a fan and it starts rotating? We have heard this most often that there is a motor inside the fan which helps it in rotating. Now the question arises, what exactly is there inside this motor? In today's video, we'll get to learn about the equipment which is known as an electric motor, along with its principle and working closely. Electric motor does not rotate when electric current flows through it only, but it rotates when electric current flowing through a conductor is placed in the magnetic field. If you look at the cross section of this motor, then loads of wire and magnets can be seen. Let us understand its working closely. If a rectangular coil ABCD is placed in a magnetic field and the ends of the coil are connected with the source of the electricity, the electric current starts flowing through the coil when we put on the switch. If we apply Fleming's left-hand rule on the arm AB of the coil, then we get the direction of the force exerted on this arm by the magnet. We know that the direction of the magnetic field is from north to south. Also, the current is flowing in this direction on arm AB. Then the force will be exerted downwards. What will happen if we apply the same rule on the arm CD of the coil? The current is flowing in the outward direction on CD, then the force will be exerted in the upwards direction. If you look into the motion, then due to force acting on both the arms of the coil, it starts rotating. After half cycle, AB and CD will interchange their positions and the direction of current would also get changed in both the arms. Does this make any sense? Have you ever seen any fan or cooler that rotates in one direction for some time and then changes its direction? No, both of them keep rotating in one direction only. Then what exactly are we missing in the motor to keep it rotating in one direction only? Split ring. Split ring is introduced in the system to keep the rotation in one direction only. Split ring is a special kind of ring which has two halves. The ends of the coil are connected with these halves, which are then connected to the circuit with the help of carbon brushes, which helps to keep the flow of electric current in one direction only in the circuit. Also, the force acted on the arms AB and CD will help the motor to keep rotating in one direction by changing its direction. Let's see this for the second time. When the current flows through the circuit, then a force acts on the arm AB and CD in downwards and upwards direction respectively. After half the cycle, the force acted on CD and AB in downwards and upwards direction respectively, and the cycle repeats itself. Commonly in electric motors, electromagnets are used in place of magnets. Electromagnets can be formed by putting a soft iron core in the coil. This we have already covered in a previous video. Electric motor is used in fans, water pumps, air cooler, grinder, mills, and in huge industries. Remember we said that Fleming's left hand rule is a really important rule in physics. Today we proved the hypothesis too. Hope you have understood the concept behind the working of the motor. If not, then don't worry, just rewind this video again. In our last video, we understood what happens when a current-carrying conductor is placed in a magnetic field. We also understood Fleming's left-hand rule and the working principle of electric motor and its applications like fan, refrigerator, computer, and washing machine. All these equipments work on electricity. Have you ever thought about how we generate electricity? Electricity is generated by an electric generator. An electric generator works on the principle of electromagnetic induction. We have heard of electromagnets, but what does electromagnetic induction mean? Let's understand the electromagnetic induction with the help of this activity. To perform this activity, we need a coil of wire having 50 number of turns, a bar magnet, and a galvanometer. What is galvanometer? Galvanometer is a device which is used to detect the presence of current in the circuit. After connecting the galvanometer in the circuit in this fashion, take the north pole of the magnet near the coil. Then a deflection in the galvanometer's needle can be seen in the direction. Let us assume the deflection is on the right side. Deflection in the needle proves that there is electric current in the coil. This needle comes back to zero as soon as the motion of the magnet stops. In the same way, if we withdraw the north pole away from the coil, then deflection in the opposite side can be seen in the needle, which shows the current is flowing in the opposite direction in the circuit. In the second case, we keep the magnet stationary and move one end of the coil towards the north pole of the magnet. Then the needle will show the deflection on the right hand side and will show deflection on the left side if we move coil away from the magnet. In the third case, if we move the south pole of the magnet towards the coil, then the deflection will be opposite than it was in case 1. So we can infer from this activity that when coil and magnet both are stationary, then there is no deflection in the galvanometer. The motion of the coil or magnet induces a potential difference which sets up an induced electric current in the circuit. Let's take this activity one step ahead. Here, replace the magnet with another current-carrying coil having 100 number of turns. We can hold the two coils with the help of a hollow cylinder of cardboard. When we put on the switch after connecting the coil 1 with the battery, then a momentary deflection can be seen in the needle of the galvanometer in one direction, and the needle jumps back to zero quickly. If we put off the switch, then as well a deflection can be seen, but in the opposite direction. If the direction of the current in coil 1 is reversed and the switch is on, then as well a deflection can be seen in the needle of the galvanometer but in the opposite direction. So we can infer from this activity that when the current is flowing at the constant rate in the coil 1, then there is no effect on the galvanometer connected with the coil 2. When the electric current changes in the coil 1, then in coil 2, a potential difference is induced. Coil 1 is known as the primary coil and coil 2 is known as a secondary coil. There is a change in the magnetic field around coil 1 when the current changes. Due to this, the magnetic field of the secondary coil also changes, which induces an electric current in the circuit. The process by which a changing magnetic field in a conductor induces current in another conductor is known as electromagnetic induction. Michael Faraday experienced this for the first time in history. To find the direction of this induced current, Fleming's right-hand rule is being used. This rule states that if the index finger, middle finger and the thumb of the right hand stretched so that all the three are mutually perpendicular to each other, then index finger will represent the direction of magnetic field lines, thumb will represent the direction of the motion, then the middle finger will give the direction of the induced current. As Fleming's left-hand rule tells the direction of the force acted due to the electric current and magnetic field, conversely, Fleming's right-hand rule gives the direction of the induced current when a conductor is placed in a changing magnetic field. In the upcoming video, we'll understand the working of an electric generator, which is an application of electromagnetic induction. There are two types of devices, first which consumes electricity and second which generates electricity. A device which converts mechanical energy into electrical energy is known as electric generator. You can see this generator in your houses or industries. In case of electric motors, the coil is rotated when electric current is passed through the coil placed in the magnetic field. Whereas in the case of electric generators, electricity is generated by rotating the coil in the magnetic field. Electric motor converts electrical energy into mechanical energy, whereas an electric generator converts mechanical energy into electrical energy. Let's understand the working principle of the electric generator. Let's take the example of the electric motor first. What will happen if we rotate the coil in place of connecting it with electricity? We already know that if we rotate the conductor in the magnetic field, then it will generate electricity. Before finding the direction of induced electric current, let us do a small change in the setup. Replace the split ring with two complete rings and watch what effect this change would have on the system. Rotate the coil in clockwise direction with the help of an axle. Then use Fleming's right-hand rule to find out the direction of the induced current. Axle is rotating in clockwise direction. That means arm AB would have a motion in upwards direction, which can be represented by the thumb. The index finger represents the direction of the magnetic field. Then the middle finger will show the direction of induced current on the arm AB, which is inwards in the case. Likewise, we can find the direction of induced current on the arm CD, which is in the outwards direction. A galvanometer can be used to show the flow of current in the external circuit. It can be seen that after half cycle, CD will rotate in the upwards direction and AB will rotate in the downwards direction, due to which the direction of the induced current will also change. And this process of change in the direction of induced current will take place after every half cycle. These types of generators are known as AC generators. What is this AC? The current which changes its magnitude continuously in direction after a regular interval of time is known as alternating current. And the current which does not change its magnitude and direction with time is known as direct current or DC. The current we get from batteries is an example of DC. Whereas the power supply in our homes is an example of AC. You must be wondering how a DC generator works. In the starting of the video, we replace the split ring with two complete rings. If we put it back, then we will get a DC current. These generators are known as DC generators. DC generators are commonly used as alternators in automobiles. Their work is to charge the batteries. We started our journey with a simple magnet. See, where are we right now? We somehow understood how one can generate electricity. There is no limit in science. The deeper you dive, the more you understand.